What did you figure out from Burrow? What are we going to see from him?
Yeah.
Because no one's talking about the Bengals. 0.
No one's talking about the Bengals.
Nobody.
0.0. And it's unbelievable because this is a guy who 19 months ago had the best college season of all time. Efficiency-wise, he was maybe the coolest-looking quarterback of all time when he's chomping on a cigar after the national championship game. And I talked to him. First of all, he's a very blunt and honest person. And I was excited to hear about that. There were some dark times for him. He basically said, you know, he went from, as we said, national champion, hugely famous college quarterback, to 9 months later, he couldn't go to the bathroom without somebody helping him and moving his leg, basically. And so there was some soul searching that went on there.
Wow.
But I also think that I think they know what he's good at. And so one of the interesting things that Brian Callahan, the OC there in Cincinnati, told me was, A, they're letting him run some of the meetings there, the offensive meetings, and they want him to get, ideally, and Callahan was a former Broncos assistant, they want him to get into Peyton Manning mode, which means his vision is so good. Burrow's vision is so good, and he's able to get five guys out into a route and diagnose it. They want him to be able to get to the mode where he's at the line of scrimmage, basically changing all the plays up to where it's his offense. And with Burrow, that's the kind of offense you can do because he's so good at processing. I'd say the drawback is Burrow told me he wants five guys out into a route, which is not necessarily normal in the NFL, but also he's trying to get healthy, Rich. And so you want as much protection as possible. So there's a push and a pull there. And there's, I think, a little bit of wrestling with that and grappling with that, where do we get all these guys out in a route so Burrow can be Burrow, or do we keep some guys in to block because we don't want him to get hit at all? So I think the answer is going to be get those guys into a route, but he's got to throw it very quickly. I think that Burrow still has the capability to show us this year he's on the superstar track, because I don't think that team's good enough to win 9, 10, 11 games. I don't think that's necessarily going to happen.
Right.
But what I am saying is that we can see he's on that superstar track. They go 8-9, and we feel good about 2022.
Well, I mean,
I think that there's still some huge team building issues that not even Burrow can overcome.
Well, I'll tell you what, man. I mean, before he got hurt, he was getting his ass kicked, and he was still performing very well. I mean, he really was, and that was, other than the fact that, you know, you blow your knee out, it's obviously a shame. But to have a season cut short when he was taking the lumps, that's what we keep talking about. Should the Bears start Justin Fields or not? You know, and you take your lumps and you go.
Yeah.
You take your lumps, and the lumps eventually allow you to progress faster, most likely, than the other. And he didn't have that. And that's the conversation we're going to hear about the Bears and Justin Fields and Andy Dalton, who says it's his time and like he's going to say anything else. You know, but it's right for him to say that, because what are you going to say? Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.